Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship on this third Sunday of Easter, right? Third Sunday? Yes. Glad you're all here today on a beautiful spring morning, finally some sunshine. A few announcements before we begin our worship. We were not able to hold the outdoor cleanup yesterday due to the wetness, I guess, of the earth. So that is rescheduled for next Saturday, the 20th, 9 to noon. If you were planning to come, that would be wonderful if you can come that day. And then our Coastal Mix concert is this afternoon at 3 o'clock. There are still tickets available if you would like to come. It's a benefit concert for the church, so all the proceeds go to us. And I didn't mention it last week, and nobody said anything to me except for one person about the sign. And the April Fool's joke that the company played on us by spelling Trinity incorrectly. So if you didn't see the pictures, they're in the e-news. They've patched it with the correct spelling, and they will be replacing the sign. So I was very embarrassed for about 30 seconds, and then I thought it was hilarious. And then also we're taking reservations for Spring Chicken Bingo Saturday, April 27th at noontime. It's lunch. And we do, if you are a baker and would like to bake in behalf of the Dorcas Mission Guild, we're having a quick bread sale at the beginning of May, and we do have tins available if you'd like to use them. So please see me or Karen or Noreen or Barbara or Tina. We can all help you out. And I think that's about it. There is a new Trumbull Health Department and an organization from Trumbull called Sustainable Trumbull are now accepting lots of little plastic things that usually can't go in your recycling. There's a list also in the e-news. If you have these things and you'd like them to be recycled, you can bring them, drop them off here, just label them for that, and we will get them to the health department. So that's a really nice opportunity. And we have some birthdays this week. We wish a very happy birthday on the 17th to Eugene Nagy, on the 18th to Mr. Christopher Andrade. Is this a big one? No, not yet. Okay.
Pushing,
okay. You're almost to the top of the hill. And on the 19th to Gabriella Rosa, and on the 20th to Hartley Farrow, and a very happy anniversary on the 16th to Michael and Kimberly Valovich. So happy birthday, happy anniversary. And let us pray the birthday and anniversary prayer at the back of your bulletin. O God, our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our worship begins with a remembrance of baptism, so I invite you to stand as you are able and face the font. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood, you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea, you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By water and your word, you claim us as daughters and sons, making us heirs of your promise and servants of all. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life. And above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And I forgot to announce, it is the second Sunday of the month, so we will be singing the Lord's Prayer during communion.
Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
us to be your children. Fill us with your words of life, that we may live as witnesses to the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Acts. Peter addressed the people, "You Israelites, why do you wonder at this? Or why do you stare at us as though by our own power or piety we had made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the holy and righteous one and asked to have a murderer given to you, and you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And by faith in his name itself has made this man strong, whom you see and know. And the faith that is through Jesus has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled that what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out." The word of the Lord. Let us read together Psalm 4 responsively. Answer me when I call, O God, defender of my cause. You set me free when I was in distress. Have mercy on me and hear my prayer. Know that the Lord does wonders for the faithful. The Lord will hear me when I call. Offer the appointed sacrifices and put your trust in the Lord.
Many are saying, "Who will show us any good? Let the light of your face shine upon us, O Lord."
You have put gladness in my heart more than when grain and wine abound.
In peace I will lie down to sleep, for you alone are Lord, and in rest secure. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, it is now, and it will be forever. Amen.
A reading from 1 John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is right is righteous, just as he is righteous. The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 24th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus himself stood among the disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. I invite the children forward.
Where's Caroline? Did she leave? Hi, Everly. How are you? Are you good? Did she sit on you? She wants to be close. Good morning. How are you today? Did you hear the story I just read about Jesus?
Yep.
What happened?
He's
alive. He has risen, right? And he shows up to who? To the disciples, yeah. And do they think it's him at first?
No.
No, they're like scared out of their minds, right? They think it, what do they think Jesus is?
A stranger
or a ghost. Ooh, spooky, right? But
yeah.
Jesus isn't a ghost, is he?
Yeah, no.
And how does he tell them that he's not a ghost? What does he do? How does he prove it? Mm-hmm. He told them, that's right. And he shows them, yeah. So they hear it with their ears, they see it with their eyes, and what else does he say?
You can touch
him, right? He says, "Look in my hands, you can see the marks where the nails went in." That's pretty cool, isn't it? Because if you can touch somebody, then you know they're real, right? If you can feel it and see it and hear. So that's all great for the disciples because they got to see Jesus alive right after Easter. It's not great for Jesus. Why? He'd gone through a lot. This is true. He had to go through death to be raised from the dead. You're right. That's not an easy thing. But now he's alive. But do we see him like that? Does he show up for us in that way exactly? No, you're right. But does he show up for us?
Yes.
Good. Great answers. So I want to know how in this room right here, I can see four different ways that we can actually see and touch and hear that Jesus is alive and here for us. We can see the cross. We can see Jesus on the cross. We could touch that cross even, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Flowers.
We can see the flowers. What did we start? Where did we start church this morning?
At the font.
At the font. Yeah. What happens at the font? Do you know?
You get baptized.
You get baptized there. And you can also remember that you're baptized. And what do we have in the font?
In water.
Water. So when we use the water and we say, "I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit," then God promises, Jesus promises that he's going to be there. He shows up. So if we touch the water, is that like we're touching Jesus?
Yes.
Awesome. And you can also, when you leave today, you can dip your hand in the water and make the sign of the cross on your head and remember, Jesus is blessing you. And what else? So that one, we can see the water, we can feel the water, we can even hear the water being poured, right? What else? What do we do in the middle of the service or toward the end?
Prayer.
What do we do behind me? What do we do here? Communion. Yeah. So what do we have at communion? One of these days, Brody, you will have your first communion too. Right. So what do we get to see and feel and touch?
Wine.
What else?
The big cup.
The big cup, the chalice. And what else do you eat?
Food,
bread. Yeah, we have bread and wine. And what did Jesus say about those things? This is my body given for you and my blood shed for you. Yes. So do you get to see the wine and the bread? Do you get to touch the wine and the bread? You get to eat the wine and the bread. That's kind of crazy. So you get, and that's Jesus for us. Drink it, yeah. And then I have, okay, that's two. What's this? It's the Bible. What do we know about the Bible?
Read.
Yeah, it's a big, it's a book of many, many wonderful stories. Soap opera stories. You want some drama? Read Genesis. Gospels that tell us all about Jesus. Letters from Paul that teach us how to be the church. Prophets that warn us and give us hope. And beautiful poetry. And do you know what Jesus was called when he was sent by God in the Gospel of John?
Bible?
No, it starts with a word W. Ugh, I get it. I did this in confirmation. I gave it away. It starts word. With the letter W. Say it again, whoever said it.
Word.
Word, right? Jesus
word
is the word of God, right? So can you see this Bible?
It's all words.
Yeah. Can you touch this Bible? Can you touch it? Brody, good job. And you can... and you can hear it if somebody reads it to you, right? And who are we? Who do we learn the most about in the Bible?
Jesus and God.
Jesus and God. And so that's number three way that we can see Jesus and be with him, and we can touch and feel and know that he's alive from the Holy Scripture. And then what's one last way? Who is all gathered here today?
Congregation.
The congregation. So can you touch me?
Yeah.
Can I touch you? Yeah. Because we are also the body of Christ. When we gather together and we hear the word and we pray and we receive the sacrament, then Jesus is with us, right? And so we get to kind of be Jesus. And how can we be Jesus to other people? What can we do? We can help people. What else? Love them. We can pray for them. We can be kind, right? We can be patient. We can be funny. Make people laugh. Bring them joy. So lots of ways. So everybody here, if you want to know if Jesus is alive, what do? Look around you. It's pretty cool, huh? So many ways to know that Jesus is alive, just like when he showed up all those years ago to the disciples. He's still here for us all the time. Yeah, and we have beautiful icons, too, that we can look at. Mm-hmm. All right, I've gone on long enough, so let's pray. You've been very patient with me. Fold your hands, bow your head. Holy and gracious God, we give you thanks for your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who rose from the dead, who appeared to his disciples, and who appears to us always in the Word, in the sacraments, in the body of Christ that are gathered to pray together, and in these boys and girls that I ask you to bless this day for Brody and Everly and Helen and Caroline and all the children of this congregation, that they would know how much you love them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you for being here today.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
It's going to be more of the same of that, but that's okay. As the Christian church was becoming the church, that is, establishing doctrine and theology that would be acknowledged and embraced and accepted among early Christians,
Our forebears endured many church councils and arguments and ultimately declarations of heretical theology and thought, especially about the person and nature, what Jesus is like, of Jesus. And I think I would have remembered better my church history if professors had related the story, maybe it's a fictitious story, that during the Council of Nicaea, St. Nicholas got so angry and frustrated that he slapped Arius across the face for saying that Jesus the Son was not equal to God the Father. But these were the types of questions that these councils and bishops and churches were asking. Is Jesus only human? Is he only divine? Did he not really have a physical body, but only the appearance of a body? And ultimately, there were three things that they figured out about Jesus and about which we still claim as a church. Number one, Jesus is completely God. Number two, Jesus is completely human. And number three, those two natures, human and divine, are somehow joined together in unity in Jesus. And those early church fathers were not the only ones wrestling with those questions about Jesus and his nature and his relationship to God and the Holy Spirit. We get to see firsthand today one of the resurrection appearances that St. Luke writes about in his gospel. And it sounds remarkably similar to John's account that we heard last week, but with a few variations. First, Thomas isn't singled out, right? And then Jesus eats food in his resurrected body. The details in this story, I think they paint such a vivid picture that the Holy Spirit opens right up and we can just step right in to that room where the disciples, with the disciples, to be witnesses to these events. And what do we see? Jesus shows up. The disciples have a particular reaction. Jesus calms them down a bit and shows them what they need to know and understand. And then they eat. I am always glad that our Christian tradition finds food to be such an important aspect of our faith and being together. They have heard the women's testimony. They have just heard from the disciples who had headed to Emmaus, and now they are seeing for themselves. But they don't really see, do they? It's almost like they haven't even heard what had been proclaimed to them. For how do they respond when they see Jesus? The disciples act in a very similar manner to the women in the Gospel of Mark and to anyone who has ever been astounded at Jesus' teaching and authority. They are startled and terrified, filled with fear initially, for they think they are seeing a spirit or a ghost, not an actual person, despite what has already been told to them. And what is so wonderful is what Jesus does next. There's no judgment. There's no scoffing at their fear. Jesus, as he always has done and always will do, gives to the disciples what they need. First, a greeting of peace and a word of comfort. And then he gives himself to them once more. This time, he allows them to see that it's really him, fully alive, fully human, fully divine, fully flesh, in the flesh. And the way he proves it is rather astounding. Jesus' resurrected body holds all that has happened before. Right? The disciples are welcome to look at his hands and his feet, to see the marks left from the crucifixion. They are even welcome to touch Jesus. And just to make sure Jesus is really alive and the real deal, he asks for something to eat. And look, no fish comes falling out of his body as if he were just a skeleton or a ghost. It's really, truly Jesus. He's really and truly alive again after he died. And what Jesus does next is foundational for our faith. It's not just
that Jesus appears to the disciples and shows he's really there and it's really him and he's really alive and he was really crucified and he is really alive again. At one level, Jesus doesn't have to do this, right? Jesus has all the vindication and the victory over death and the grave simply by being resurrected. Alleluia, Christ is risen. That's enough. But then this other thing happens. Jesus gives himself again to the disciples. Jesus uses the physicality of his resurrected body as a way of sharing himself, sharing God's grace and love, sharing the promise of the resurrection, not for his own edification or proof of life, but for the sake of the disciples. And do you know why that is so cool and so foundational for our faith? Because how we teach and understand our faith, our trust that God sent Jesus, his son, crucified and resurrected and given for you, in part stands on this resurrection appearance of Jesus in the Gospel of Luke. Our small catechism teaches that in the sacraments of baptism and in the Eucharist, God takes a tangible earthly thing like water, bread, and wine, and he sets those things alongside God's promise, God's word through Jesus. I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. This is my body given for you. This is my blood shed for you. God isn't doing this to prove he can or to make sure you know you're in line, checking off the boxes, doing the things so that you're a good Christian. When you see that water poured out and poured over your heads, when you hear those words, it is Jesus saying, look, you have been my beloved child even before you were knit in your mother's womb. But here in this water and the word, Jesus is giving himself to you so that you know, so that you do not need to be afraid, so that you will see that the scriptures are fulfilled, so that you will understand Jesus Christ and him crucified and raised, so that you are witnesses to these things. Reach into the font, touch and see that it is Jesus. And then we'll eat. And again, Jesus stands as host and meal in the banquet that we share. Jesus doesn't need to invite us to the party, but what an invitation it is to receive. How wonderful that Jesus, Son of God, our Messiah, was anointed to do this thing for you. In simple wafer, it's not even that great, bread, and ordinary wine, God gives the words that bring Jesus in with and under these foods that through the power of his Spirit then become for us the very body and blood of Jesus Christ. Our religious practices can sometimes seem mostly spiritual and divine and maybe even a little obscure. And this type of meal, Holy Communion, it can seem a little strange. But in the word with the bread and the wine, Jesus shows up once again just as he promised. And he says, here, don't be afraid. Look at my hands and my feet. Touch and see. You can receive Jesus again and again into your hands. And the marks of the crucifixion are imprinted on our wafers, right? The sign of the cross. And it is Jesus, just the same, resurrected, real, in the flesh, given and shed for you. Everything has been fulfilled. You are called children of God, for that is what you are, beloved, from the beginning. God, through Jesus Christ, will tell you that over and over through the stories and the Holy Scripture that we can put our hands on, that we can listen to with our ears, that we can see in our imaginations. And then you are marked with the cross of Christ at your baptism forever and forever,
where the water is poured out for you and the word of God is claimed for you. You are a child of God, marked with the cross of Christ and sealed by the Holy Spirit forever. And week in and week out, Jesus will invite you. Jesus will show up. Jesus will stand among you. Peace be with you. Taste and see. The body of Christ is here, given for you. It's really him, his very presence given into your hands. May he strengthen you and keep you in his grace. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God, light from light, true God from true God,
begotten not of
one being. Things were made for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
who with the
Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in the Catholic and Apostolic Church, for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Lord Jesus Christ, on this day you appeared to your disciples, transforming their fear and doubt into joy and confidence. Transform your church into your likeness, that through its word and sacraments, all people may be drawn to confident faith in you, the Savior of the world. Bless your children wherever they suffer danger or persecution for faith in you. Forgive us all our many sins, and grant to us all your peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Make this congregation called Holy Trinity and its bishops and pastor, Elizabeth, Wilma, and Kathleen, bold to proclaim you as our risen Lord. Fill us with your good news and make us reflect your holiness and love to those around us. Lord, in your mercy, deliver the people of this world from the powers of sin and death. Give them leaders who seek to do your Father's will, and fill every heart with compassion and uprightness. Provide for the needy and come to the help of all in danger. Especially we pray for this nation, our elected leaders, our communities and neighborhoods, and all whose lives are knit together with ours. Watch over all those who protect and serve others, especially Justin, that in all things your people might be established in righteousness, liberty, and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray on behalf of all those whose needs of body, mind, or soul are great, especially for Charles, Nicole, Gracie, Luke, Mariah, Janice, Ellen, John, Pietro, Joyce, Muriel, Cheryl, John, Jennifer, Tom, Martin, Carol, Karen, Ronald, Julie, Vin, Mandy, Michael, Ann, Rob and Don, Fawn, Dan, Bretta, Mary and Richard, Michael, Jennifer, Delia, Grace, Tim, Sharon, Sam, Valerie, Kathy, Michelle, Seth, Chris and Kate, Laureen, Beryl, Faith, Evelyn, Eric, Robert, Vic and Ellie, Doug and Lee, Hannah, Robin, Brian, Linda, Jacqueline, Michael, Peggy, Stephen, Mike, Alicia, John, Gary, Tracy, Amy, Bob, Marilyn, Carol, Gabriella and Gary, Marge, Arthur, Allison, Alex, Chrissy, Klaus, Jetty, Julian, Gina, John, Frank, Melissa and Jeanette, Anne Marie and Ken, those at home and in nursing homes, including Bob, Evelyn, Jane, and Lydia, and those we name on our lips and in our hearts before you now. Transform suffering into patient endurance, sorrow into enduring hope, shame into hope-filled repentance, despair into new life, and the power of death into living joy. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, you promised your resurrection life to all people. We thank you for fulfilling that promise to those who have died, trusting in you, especially all the faithful departed of Holy Trinity and all those we remember in our hearts. Comfort those who mourn. Walk with us throughout our pilgrim journey. And at the last, transform us into your blessed likeness so that with all your saints, we may see you face to face. Lord, in your mercy,
into your hands, gracious God, we and all fervently pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
You, O God, ruler of heaven and earth, day by day you shower us with blessings. As you have raised us to new life in Christ, give us glad and generous hearts, ready to praise you and to respond to those in need, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Blessed are you, O God of the universe. Your mercy is everlasting, and your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for saving the earth from the waters of the flood. Praise to you for bringing the Israelites safely through the sea. Praise to you for leading your people through the wilderness to the land of milk and honey. Praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the death and resurrection of Christ. Praise to you for your spirit poured out on all nations. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With this bread and cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life, as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. O God of resurrection and new life, pour out your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts of bread and wine. Bless this feast. Grace our table with your presence. Come, Holy Spirit. Reveal yourself to us in the breaking of the bread. Raise us up as the body of Christ for the world. Breathe new life into us. Send us forth burning with justice, peace, and love. Come, Holy Spirit. With your holy ones of all times and places, with the earth and all its creatures, with sun and moon and stars, we praise you, O God, blessed in Holy Trinity, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to sing.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Life-giving God, in the mystery of Christ's resurrection, you send light to conquer darkness, water to give new life, and the bread of life to nourish your people. Send us forth as witnesses to your Son's resurrection, that we may show your glory to all the world through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen. Amen. Amen.